today we are going to start our discussion about ILD by Euler principle, right? Mm-hmm. Last time I told you how to draw it, but in this class first we will practice it. How to draw the ILD by using Euler principle means qualitative ILDs. Okay? So our discussion is about ILD by simple idea is first consider the resistance to so project is finished from here, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So
another class?
لا لا كل الكلاسات. All classes they remove it.
جاء واحد صار.
For maintenance.
لا.
Yeah, for maintenance. From all classes.
From all classes.
Yes.
في واحد بس ترى.
For maintenance or someone thieves.
No, 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 no.
Yes, maybe. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the Euler principle by using some examples. Okay, so first one is draw ILD, draw qualitative ILD. Reaction at A. ILD for reaction at A. So now we have this B. This is point A, this is point B. Now I want to draw the ILD for reaction at A. So what will be first step? First step is you need to put the resistance of that function
zero
at that point equal to zero. So we want to make ILD for RA over here, then for reaction, what do we suppose? We suppose a roller guide over there, is it?
Yes.
So it means I am going to suppose a roller guide at point A. So over here I am replacing it by roller guide. And then what next? And this are all other things are as it is, okay? This length is 1 meter and this length is, for example, 4 meters. So all these things are as it is. Okay, then. What next? Now we are going to apply the function as a load. Okay? So and draw the reform shape. Here, what is our function? RA, okay? So due to this one, its deform shape will be somewhere like this. So therefore, this is the shape of the ILD, right? And we got an idea that the ILD for R is okay. So this is the simple way, right? So this is qualitative ILD
for R.
Qualitative ILD for R A. Yes. So this will be the shape of ILD. It is a straight line. Easy, right?
Yes.
Now let's draw for the another example. This example is continued. It's part 2. ILD for RB, for example, for this case.
Doctor.
Yes.
It must pass through the support or loose?
Yes. So your ILD, usually it passes through the supports. Okay. Unless and until you are providing a roller guide. Okay.
So if you are giving reaction direction, it's downward, not upward.
No. Reaction always you will consider upward. Okay.
Always.
Yeah. Reaction
even
is
that negative.
I told you the direction of reaction is upward.
Hmm.
For shear, left side down, right side up,
yes.
And movement on left side, counterclockwise, right side clockwise. Okay.
So there is no negative reaction.
Negative is not possible. Okay. Now ILD for RB. So now we have this beam, okay, and in this one, this is point B, this is point A, okay? So suppose these lengths are 2 meter and 4 meter and 2 meter. So now what we will do over here?
First we
resistance on P will be
RB. So we make the resistance means vertical reaction at B equals to 0. Means it cannot resist anything. Okay?
Yes.
Then what will happen?
We change to roller guide, a type of roller guide over here, okay?
And this port is as it is. Then you apply the reaction at that point, okay? Because this is point A, this is point B, right? So you need to apply RB over here, okay? And the distances will remain same, right? 2 meter, 4 meter, and then you make its deformed shape. What will be its deformed shape? Mind it, we are not going to cut it. Actually, what I am doing, I am considering that this roller spore, right, it do not provide the reaction. This is only consumption, right? And then this is a straight line. So when you apply this reaction upward, so what will happen? Can you see this line is continuous, right?
Yes.
This line is continuous, okay? Clear? So when I provide this reaction upward, then how it will deform? This will deform like over here, this will move upward. Up to this one, and then it will pass through this port, is it?
Yes.
So this will be its deformed shape, is it? So from here we got an idea about the shape of ILD, is it clear?
Yes.
So the ILD for RB, right, it will be so it's easy. Over here it will be, it is passing through the spore and it is moving like this. Is it clear?
Yes.
So in this part it will be positive, here it will be negative. And mind it, these distances are known or not known?
No.
2 meter.
4 meter, 2 meter.
So this is your qualitative ILD for our shape of ILD for. Okay, now let's draw for the shear force. Okay, so next part 3, draw ILD for shear force at point C. Draw ILD for shear force at point C. So here is point A. This is point, this A, B, C, this is point D, this is B, okay. So we need to draw ILD for shear force at C, right? These distances are 1.5, 2, 2 and 1.5, okay. 1.5, 2 meter, 2 meter and 1.5, okay. So what is first step? We need to consider the resistance 0. For shear force, what do we do?
We
consider the roller guide.
Roller
okay,
guide.
At that point, we provide a roller guide. Okay, so what will be done? So in this case, so over here is our roller spore. Here is the pin spore. And we want to draw the ILD at this point. So at this point, what you are going to do?
Right,
you are going
to
cut it, right? And put a
roller guide.
And so mainly now you are this element, right? It is connected with this roller guide and this is connected with this one. Is it okay?
Yes.
Okay. So now on the left side you will apply the
downward
force and on the right side you will apply the. So it, this is the shear, okay?
Okay.
Now what will be the deformed shape for this case?
So this force,
it will deform like this way, is it?
Yes.
And this portion it will move upward and it will deform like this way. So it means your overall deformed shape will be somewhere here, is it? This portion, it will deform like this one.
Mm-hmm.
And this portion, it will deform like this. Agree?
Yes.
Okay. So this gives you the ILD, shape of ILD for shear force. Clear? So this will give you, and mind it, these distances are given, right?
Doctor, can you make the line, please?
This one?
Yes, this one.
will pass through this port, okay? In this manner also, right? Clear?
But resistance.
Okay, and this is 1.5 meter. This is 2 meter, this is 2 meter, this is 1.5 meter. Okay. Then next one is, now from this deformed shape we can get the idea of ILD. So we will have the shape of ILD will be like this one at this point, this one, this one. Okay. So we have the ILD like this one, and then it will move like this. So here it is negative, here it is positive, negative and positive, is it?
Yes.
And you know these distances, right?
Yes.
So these distances are 2 meter,
no,
1.5 meter, 2 meter, 2 meter and 1.5 meter. What is this one? This is shape of ILD for
shear force at point C.
For shear force at point C. Okay. Now let's draw it for bending movement. Last one is for
bending movement.
Bending movement. Okay. So now part 4, right? Now draw ILD for example bending movement at C. Exactly similar. Okay. Draw ILD for bending movement at ILD for bending moment at point C. Okay, here, what you can in this case, beam is like this one. It's four point C is here now, right? So this is not in meter, 1.5 meter, 1 meter. 3 meter, and this is 1.5 meter.
Yes.
Okay. So now what we have to do?
Put
so first for the whenever you need to draw the ILD for bending moment, what do you consider an internal hinge at that point? Okay.
Yes.
Because when you at internal hinge, what
moment
is bending
is
moment?
Zero.
It is
zero.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. So we will consider internal hinge at that point. So over here we are considering internal hinge at point A. Okay. And then what next? On the left side, we are applying the counterclockwise movement, and on right side, clockwise movement. So here we are applying M in this direction, here we are applying. So this is the same position for every case.
Internal hinge at point C.
At that point where you need the ILD for bending movement. Okay. Now when you will apply this one, how it will tilt? How it will deform? This will deform like this one. And this part, it will deform like, is it?
Yes.
So this will be the shape of ILD for bending moment. Okay. So distances are available with us. 1.5 meter, 1 meter, 3 meter and 1.5 meter. Okay. Now the shape of ILD will be, so over here, what will be shape of ILD? It is similar to this one, right? So here it is like this one. Is it okay?
Yes.
This is shape of ILD, right?
What's about for now at the left and right?
Okay, I will solve such problem. Okay, so here it is positive, here it is
negative.
Okay. Clear? So this is the shape of ILD for
bending
for bending movement. A very common question, right? Now, for this case, it's easy to find the reaction. Reaction is over here. Now for shear force, if I ask you to draw the ILD for shear force at point C, and point C is here, exactly in between. Okay?
Yes.
Can you understand my question?
Yes.
No, yes. C is not here, C is here, okay? So in this one, C is not here, it is here, exactly in between. Okay? tend to draw the ILD.
Yes.
Okay. And this is the question. This question was an exam, right? Last time. Okay. So I give not here, right? So in between we solved it. I have to draw for this point. You understand?
Yes.
Okay. What will be shear over here?
Zero.
But my our this example is over, right?
Yes.
I draw it for reaction shear force bending moment. Now a little bit extra discussion. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay. So now how to draw the ILD for shear force over here? You need to be quick, okay?
Yes.
Zero.
So what we will do? We will put this roller guide over here, right?
Yes.
And then you deform, draw the deformed shape. Is it?
Yeah.
I am doing over here. Is it okay?
Yes.
Instead of writing all these things, okay? So when you put the roller guide over here, on the left side, you need to apply downward, right side, upward. What will be its deformed shape? Are you agreed with this?
The left side will not change. But
the left side will not change. And right side?
At the right side, it will be
Upward.
It will be
upward.
So it can be pass through the two spot.
Yes, it has to pass through the spot, okay?
Yes, so from negative to...
from negative to positive.
No.
Okay, so I can tell you, right? So when you are going to cut it over here, you are applying this side downwards force, so what will happen? It will go down exactly like this way.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes.
It will go down as it is like this way. It will not rotate in this direction or this direction, is it? Because this is the member, right? Now you cut it, right? You cut it over here. So now you are applying shear over here. So what will happen? It will go down as it is it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So this part, it will go down like, after this here, it will go down like this. This is clear, right? Okay, then what about this part?
Remain the same position.
It will remain at same position. It will not go up or down, right?
Yes.
Because in this one, it has two spots, right?
Mm.
Okay, if it is one spot, it can rotate, right? But now it has two spots. So this portion, it will remain as it is.
Mm.
Clear? So this is the shape of ILD only. Agreed?
Yes.
Clear?
Okay.
Not clear? Just cut it, okay? And on the left side, apply the downward force. So this portion, it will come down as it is, right? But for this portion, it has two spots, this one and this one, right?
Okay.
It cannot come down, it cannot go up, it cannot rotate.
Yes.
It will remain as it is. Clear? Now, what about this portion for bending movement?
Same.
No, not same. Now, apply the movement in this direction and in this direction, exactly like this one, okay?
Yes.
Now, what will be the deformed shape?
Smooth triangle.
So, now from here, it will tilt like this one, is it?
Yes.
Okay? Because you are, this is internal hinge, right? So it will be cut like this one.
Mm-hmm.
Clear?
Okay.
And what about this part?
No.
No change. It will remain straight. Okay?
Yes.
So I think this was the question in exam. Exactly these ones. Shear force and bending moment for point C. And point C was an overhanging part. Yes?
To remain straight, even point C. There is point internal hinge.
Here at C?
Yes.
Is there this point or this point? You are talking about this one or this one?
Is there point C in this shape?
Now I am asking you, point C is not here, right? So I am asking you, point C is here and draw
this. There is point C. Add the shape to this shape.
Yeah, you need to draw this shape and so on, right? But I am solving over here directly, okay? So this is...
Between this one, like curve, this one, point C.
Mm-hmm.
For shear or for movement?
For shear.
For shear,
okay,
then.
For shear,
this is our original
example,
okay?
So this is the example. Point C is here. Everything is point, right? What is your question? So this is our example, right? So it's over. So now I am asking you to solve a second example, right? Okay, and move C over here. Okay, and how to do it? Then you need to draw this figure and this figure, right? But I am doing it over here just to give you an idea. Okay. Okay. So until now, we discussed that how to draw the ILD, right? For the shape of ILDs. Okay. Next discussion is how to convert the qualitative ILD to quantitative ILD. You understand?
Yes.
How to convert the from this shape, right? This is shape of ILD. How to get values over here, here, and here, right? Clear? How to get this value, this one, and this one. How to get this value, and this value. Clear? Okay, now, for example, I told you this value, right? I told you this value, right? Then, can you find this one?
Yes.
Yes.
Because these are the triangles, right?
Mm-hmm.
When this is known, I told you what is this total value. You can find this one and this one, right?
Yes.
Similarly, over here, if I tell you this value, you know this 1.5. Can you find this one?
Yes.
So it means out of whole figure, so you need to find only one value.
Yes.
Okay. If one value is known, other you can find it. Numerically, is it?
Same yes. Triangle.
Triangle, right? So if I told you that this value is, for example, 1, okay?
Mm.
Then this is 4, right? This will be 6. What will be this one?
This will be 1 over 4 equal x over 6.
So if I tell you that this is 1, right?
Yes.
Can you find what will be this one?
Yes.
It is 1 over 4 into
x.
This one divided by
6,
right?
Yeah.
So this will give you 1.5. Is it?
Yes. No, 1.5.
3 over 2.
1.6, yes.
1.5.
Yes.
And if this is 1, this is 4, then this is 2, what will be this one? This is 0.5. So it means to find all these ordinates, you need at least one value. Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Anyone. If I told you this is 0.75, still you can go with it, right?
Yes.
Okay, so this is our next discussion. How to convert from qualitative ILD to quantitative ILDs, okay? Now next discussion is to convert from qualitative to quantitative ILDs. Okay, any idea from your side?
Doctor, we can apply a unit load to the required point.
Let's find reaction and
yes.
We can get everything.
Okay, convert the qualitative ILD to quantitative . Okay, so if you can understand its basic, then it will be easy for you to apply it, okay? How to convert it. Now, in this figure, right, what is this one? This is ILD for RB, is it? Okay. So I am going to erase this part because this was just a helping part to draw the shape of ILD. Is it okay?
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
Okay. So now, what is meaning of this ordinate? What is meaning of this ordinate?
The value of RB.
So this is value of RB
when unit load is at point B.
When unit load is exactly over here, is it?
Yes.
Right. So what you can do, you can consider unit load over here. Okay. And similarly. Now, what is our meaning of this one? What is meaning of this ordinate?
The value of RB.
Value of RB when unit
load
is. This is value of RB when unit load is over here.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes.
So this is value of RB when unit load is over here. Okay.
Yes.
So what I can do, I can actually place a unit load over here, and I can find the value of RB and RA.
Yes.
Okay. I can place exactly a unit load and the actual beam over here, okay, and find RB, okay?
Yes.
So that will be this value, isn't that so?
Yes.
So now I place a unit load over here. What will be this one? This will be 1.5. This will be 0.5 in over there. Okay. So now, when unit load is here, what is value of RB? It is
1.5.
So it means what is this RB? This is
1.5.
Can you understand? Okay. Now over here, what is meaning of this figure? What is meaning of this figure? This is I and D
for
shear force at point
C.
C.
Okay, so now I am going to erase this part because what is this one? This was just an intermediate step, right? Okay, then what is meaning of this ordinate? It means if your unit load is here,
so value of shear
then
force,
value of shear force at point C is this one, okay?
Yes.
Okay, so if your unit load is here, right? Unit load is here. What will be the value of shear force at C? This one from here to here. Is it?
Yes.
This will be the value of shear force at C.
Two
values. So, prove two values. So, what I can do now, I can actually place a unit load here. Okay.
Fine.
Okay, what will be this reaction? Can you tell me?
Half
and half, right?
Yes.
And draw the shear force. What will be shear force for this case? Is there shear force over here? No, right?
No.
So this will be 0.5 up, then remain same, then 0.5 down, and is it?
Yes.
Can you get this idea?
Yes.
Yes.
So it means when unit load is at point C, when unit load is at point C, what is shear force at C?
0.5.
Minus half and half.
So minus half and half, this one, right? And this one will be exactly same over here. Okay, so this is plus 0.5 and this is minus 0.5.
Mm-hmm.
So we are going a little bit in reverse direction, okay? Right? Okay, again, if your unit load is here, okay, you can draw a shear force diagram, right? You can find the value of shear force. Now place this one, that if unit load is here, this is the value of shear force on this diagram. Where it will be? Obviously here and here. Okay, now, for this case, okay, for this case, right, how to do it?
Same thing.
Again,
we have to draw a bending moment.
This is the intermediate step, right? This is our final ILD, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the meaning of that? If unit load is here, right, then the value of shear bending moment at point C is this one. Is it? So I am going to place, for example, if I place a unit load over here, what is value of bending moment at point C? This one, right?
Yes.
Okay, so actually I am finding the value of bending moment at that point, okay? So let's find it. Can you tell me this reaction? This will be, I think, 0.75 and this will be
0.25,
okay? And then you can draw bending moment over here will be 0 here, it will change like this one, okay? So what will be this one? 0.7? Okay, 0.25 into 3, it will be. So what is meaning of this ordinate?
It's a
when unit load is at point C, then this is the value of bending moment at point C, right? So let's apply this one over here. 0.75. Now this is 0.75. Now you can complete the remaining figure. Okay. So to convert it, what are the first steps? Now I am going to write all this discussion in step by step, okay? So first one is
with a point load,
draw the qualitative ILD, right? Draw the qualitative draw the qualitative ILD. What is next step?
Place a point.
Place a unit load. Now if I simplify it, place a unit load
on the required point.
Place, yes, a unit load at the point where function is required, okay? Where function is required, okay? For example, in this case, right, what do you need? You need RB, right? ILD for RB. So what you have to do? Place unit load at point
B.
In this case, what do you need? You need shear force at point
C.
Place unit load at point C. Here, you need bending moment at point C. So place unit load at point C. Okay. Then next step is then find the value of function. Find the value of function at that point. For example, what do you need? You need RA, right? Okay, find the value of RA from here. What it is? 1.0 and 0, is it? Find the value of function, okay? Over here, 1.0. So what is your value of function? It is 0.5 and minus 0.5. The last one, by comparing triangles, find the remaining ordinates of IND. Okay. Find the remaining ordinates of IND. Clear? Okay, very quickly, I am going to. Do I rewrite these examples for you? Now question is this one. This is the situation, right? Okay, this is our next example. Okay. Draw ILD for RA. Okay. Draw ILD for RA by using Mueller principle. Okay. Draw ILD for RA by using Mueller's principle. Okay. When this is the statement, it means you need to draw the
quantitative
ILD. Okay. So when it is asked draw ILD, not shape of ILD, you need to draw the complete ILD with values. Okay. So what will be the first step in the solution? First, draw the shape of IND, right?
Yes.
And it is for RA. This is A, okay? Draw for RA, okay?
Okay.
So, what you have to do?
First you have to put
so, draw the qualitative IND, okay? How to draw qualitative IND?
Put a roller guide.
Put a roller guide at that point. Okay? And apply the function over there. And draw the deform shape, right? What will be its deform shape? This will move up, right?
So
deform
down
shape will be like this one. Okay. So this deform shape will be your shape of ILD, right? So over here, the shape of ILD, right? So shape of ILD will be like this, is it? So this is our shape of ILD. And shape of ILD for RA. So this is positive, this is negative. And you know these distances, right? These distances are 2, 4 and 2, right? 2 meter, 4 meter and 2 meter. What next?
Apply unit load.
Yes, now place a unit load at the point where function is required. Where function is required?
RA.
So place unit load over here. And find the values of function at that point. So what is
only
the
one
so you need to find
one.
RA, okay? So now over here, place a unit load over here, right? So this is your A point, okay? Now find, okay, place a unit load at that point where function is required. Then find the value of function at that point. So what is our function?
Only
RA. So here it will be equal to RA. It is equal to 1.0. This will be
0.
Okay. Then find the value of function. The value find in previous step. Okay. Will be same in ILD at that point. Okay. Now this value of our function, right? It is same over here. Okay. So this one is
1.
1.0 and then By comparing triangles, find the remaining ordinates of I and D, okay? So now, if this is 4, this is 1, okay?
1.5.
And if this is 6, what will be this one?
1.5.
I think it will be 1.5, is it?
Yes.
Yeah.
So now, if this is 4, this is 1, this is 2, what will be this one? Minus 0.5, okay? This is minus. So now we got the shape, the RE, its proper complete ILD by using the Euler principle. Okay. Now let's apply the same thing for the for shear force or for bending moment. What do you want? Okay, next is now example 2, right? Same problem, right? So this is 1.5 meter. This is 1.5 meter. C point is here. First, for bending movement, okay? Draw ILD for bending movement at C, right? Okay, in solution, right? What will be our first step? It is bending movement, not shear force, okay?
Yes.
Shear force I will draw later. So what will be the first step?
Draw the ILD.
Draw a qualitative ILD. For qualitative ILD for bending moment, what do you have to do? You need to consider
internal.
An internal hinge at that point, okay, like this one.
This one.
So consider an internal hinge at that point on the left side and on the right side apply the moment. Okay. This is the spot, one spot, this is the second spot. Now draw the deformed shape. What will be its deformed shape? So its deformed shape will be like this one. Right? So this deformed shape will be like this one. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay. Then what next?
Okay.
So now this deformed shape will give you the shape of ILD. Okay? So here it will be like this one and this one. And it will pass through the 0 point, is it? Now these lengths are known, okay? Clear? So this is shape of ILD. This is negative part, this is positive part, this is negative, okay? So this is 1.5 meter, this is 2 meter, this is 2 meter, this is 1.5 meter. Okay, what next? Draw the qualitative ILD. Place unit load at the point where function is required.
Yes.
Where you need the function?
At C.
At C, right? So now place a unit load exactly at that point, okay? Exactly at that point, place a unit load. Okay, place a unit load at the point where function is equal. Then find the value of function at that point. What is our function? What is our function? It is movement at point
C.
So find the value of bending movement at point C. Okay, so this reaction will be 0.5. This reaction is
1.5.
Now its bending movement diagram will be, okay, these distances are known, right? These are 2 and 2, is it?
Yes.
1.5, 2 meter, 2 meter, and 1.5 meter. Okay, then here bending moment will be 0, here it will be maximum and 0, right? What will be bending moment over here?
0.5.
2 into 0.5?
1.
1, okay? So 2 into 0.5, it will be 1 over here and 0. So over here, this ordinate is 1. So this is ordinary bending moment diagram, okay? Right? This is our ordinary bending moment diagram. Now, find the value of function at that point. We've done it. What is next? The value in previous step will be same in ILD at that point. It means this value, it is same over here. So now this is how much it is?
1.
Okay? So this, if this is 2, this is 1, right? If this is 1.5, what will be this one? 0.75 negative. Where it will be 0.75 negative. Clear? So this is your ILD for bending movement at point C. Okay? Clear? Okay, then. So can you do it for the shear force?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it difficult or same?
No.
So if I want the shear force over here, right? I draw the shear force IRD, right? It will be like this way, right?
Yes.
Then place a unit load over here. Our shear force diagram will be like this one, and this one, right? So these two ordinates will be over here. Clear? Okay, with this one, our discussion about Muller principle is over, right? So in Muller principle, first we study how to draw the qualitative IRD. Then by using our sense of IRD, right, we try to draw the quantitative IRD. Clear? So it's easy or difficult?
Easy.
IRD for shear force, for reaction, bending moment. So we studied three methods, okay?
Yes.
One is for vibrating values. Then
by equation,
yeah. Then by Muller principle. Okay. So in which case you need less calculation?
This one.
This one.
You don't need calculation at all, right?
Yes.
Okay. It's easy. Okay. So now I am going to tell you a fourth method. Okay.
Yes.
Itself, this is not a method, right? It is just like a trick. Okay.
Okay.
To draw the IRDs blindly. Do you understand what I am saying?
Yes.
You don't need any calculation. Just remember two or three things and you will be able to draw IRD. Do you understand what I am saying?
Yes.
But it's not in the books. This is the problem, okay? But it is applicable for nearly all the cases, right? Are important. Okay, so their trick is, can you understand what I am saying?
Yes.
It is not in the books,
right? Just check.
No, you will get the final shape, right? Okay, first for the reactions. I think you can get the idea after solving so many problems, right? So this is like, I can say this is method 4, okay? And I don't have its name, okay? So what you can do, if you need the IRD for the reaction, where you need the reaction, it is always on the spots, okay? Like this one. So exactly I am going to solve this one by a direct approach, right? This was 2 and 4 and 2, right? 2 meter, 4 meter and 2 meter. So if you need the IRD at A, spot A, right?
Okay.
What do? You raise that point by unit.
Yes.
Okay. So consider, if you want to find R A, so what you will do? Consider 1 over here. Unit displacement, okay, and then displace this point by unit. So draw the deformed shape. So it will go like this one. Is it?
Yes.
It will pass through it. Now this is 1. This is 4. What will be this value? It will be 1.5. This is
0.5.
You are getting the same shape. Right. So what is the idea? If you need IRD at A.
Okay. Just raise it.
Raise that point by
one.
Clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Easy, right?
Easy. Yes.
So you don't need any calculation, right? Okay. If you need for RB, what it will be?
The opposite.
One.
Now increase this one by one.
One.
Yeah.
And then join it like this way.
Two. So
you know this is 1. This is 4. What will be this one? 1.5.
Can I use it for a moment?
For bending moment.
Yes.
No, this is for reaction only. Okay. Okay, now let's do it the same thing for the shear. Okay?
Same method?
So similar method, right? This is for
reaction,
okay? And the next is for shear force. Okay?
So,
yes?
For reaction, we take the left distance, right?
No, no, no. You take that point upward one.
Point required.
Always, point load. It's always one?
Always one. Always one. If you need at A, you need raise this point by one. If you need at B, you need. Do you need RA over here in the middle?
No,
you don't need in the middle, right? Because the action will be here or here only, right? Okay. Okay. So next, for shear force, if you want to draw, for example, for shear force, this is our B, right? Okay. I can make it. Other points as well, right? Okay, suppose this distance is you need to find the shear force at point C. These distances are 2 meters, this one is 3 meters, sorry, 2 meters, this one is 3 meters, this is also 2 meters.
Okay.
Lower by half and lower by half. Lower.
So in this case, right, so what you can do, you can consider on the right spot one down. Okay. You can consider
one down.
Over here, you can consider it as
one down.
One. How much time to go?
Four.
How much more minutes?
Three.
Then 2 more minutes. This is one, right?
Okay.
So what will be over here? Consider up one.
Yes.
Okay. So on this board, consider one down. On this board, consider
up.
Up.
Up. Okay.
Okay.
Then what you have to do?
Straight line.
Then. Join this one with this port.
No.
You need to join this one by this port and this one by this port. Now then what you have to do now? Join this point with this port, right? Okay, I am going to use the same color. So join this point with this port and increase, is it?
Yes.
Right? And then
join
this one
support.
By
this
point.
And then the straight line at that point where you need the shear force, right? You need shear force over here, is it?
Yes.
So just join this one. Now if this length is 5, this is 1, is it?
Yes.
So if this length is 3, what will be this ordinate?
0.6?
So if this length is, for example, 5, this is 1. If this is 2, what will be this one? It is 0.4, right? Okay. So over here, now this part, now line join this one and this one. This is your ILD for shear force at point C. So now this is 2, this is 0.4. This is 2, what will be this one? 0.4. This is 0.6, this is 3. This is 2, this will be 0.4.
Yes.
So this is how we can draw the
shear
force directly. Okay. And I have to draw the bending movement. Can you understand this one?
Yes.
No, right? So what you have to do? Just consider this unit up, unit down, okay? Clear? Then pass these two lines, this one and this one. Okay? Then you need shear force over here, right? Cut it like this one. Now see this top triangle, okay? This is 1, this is 5. This is 3, what will be this one? 0.6, right? So now see this bottom triangle, right? This is 1, this is 1, this is 5. If this is 2, this will be 0.4, okay? Now join it, cut it over here. Join it like this one. And join it like this one. So this will be your shape of IRD. So it is for every case. You can draw for any case by using this direct approach. For bending moment, again, do I draw for this case?
Yes.
Okay, for bending moment, what you have to do? But please do not sleep, okay? Okay, so this distance is 1.5 meters. So then what you have to do, consider this distance over here. Consider this distance over here. Consider this distance over here. Two. This distance over here.
Okay. Two.
This is also 2, right?
Okay.
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 This distance over here, this distance over here, okay. Then join this point with this one and extend it. And join this point
another support
with this point. Okay. Now this is 4, right? This is 2. If this is 2, what will be this one?
1,
right?
Oh, okay.
Okay. And this will be your ILD, right? So this is your ILD, this one, is it? This lower part, is it? So this is 1 now, right? If this is 2, this is 4. If this is 2, what will be this one? This is
1,
okay? So if this is 1, this is 2, this is 1.5, this will be
0.75.
1. And you are getting same shape, 0.75, 1.75.
The divisor might have the distance between the two supports.
So divide it. If this is 2, right?
Yeah.
Put this distance over here. If this distance, put it over here. Okay. And it is applicable for every case. Okay. But do not do it in exam. Okay.
To check.
Only just for checking it is okay, right? But do not do it in the exam, right?
Okay.
Okay, so...